Are you ready for the killer? Yeah. Are you ready for the killer?
Absolutely.
Wat was dat met dem dikke? Wat was dat met dem dikke leuk? Dat kan een kik niet pikken. Dat kan een kik niet pikken, de jeuk. Wat was dat met dem dikke? Wat was dat met dem dikke leuk? Dat kan een kik niet pikken. Dat kan een kik niet pikken, de jeuk. Is geen klappertje door, dat ken ik goed verstand. Dan rijd elke serieuze mengs al eens beoefde aan. Maar komt maar niet vertellen dat je heel de dag lang klapt. Wees hoe ver je schept, geef toe dat je mij uit ongepakt. En was het al hier wat smossen in een beetje tijdig en rust. Of het ook liggen vossen, schat, hoe ver ging dat je mus? Wat was dat met dem dikke? Wat was dat met dem dikke leuk?
I'm planting radish. You see, we made little trenches first. Then we put the seeds, see? And then we cover them a bit. And then later on, once the radish becomes bigger, they kind of grow out of the soil, we can always earth them up a bit. Because a little bit, this one is hard here. Because a little bit lower, you see?
Yeah.
It's easy to earth up.
Yeah, so when they sprout from the middle part, we just put the trenches in, so yeah, it will be earthed up.
Because you can see there are a few radish there. You see they're coming out.
Yeah.
Well, okay, but it's nice that they can be a little bit more in the soil. That's yeah, why we put trenches, so they will be better.
Yeah. And we found out that the yellow paper that we're using to attract the fruit flies are also attracting white flies.
Yeah, it's because it's yellow.
Yeah, it's yellow. See here, all the white flies, including other vectors sticking to the yellow paper. So
that's
good. It is very essential to have this kind of sticky paper at your farm. It has pheromones that attracts fruit flies, and at the same time the bright yellow color attracts other non-beneficial insects, and they get stuck in it and they don't pose a threat to our crops anymore.
Yes.
All right.
Can I have the bolo, please?
Yeah.
The bolo?
Only the bolo.
Because I will use this one to cut the dry leaves of the bananas. High time that the bananas can rest already from, oh my god, it's very dull.
It doesn't
cut at all.
The bananas are now at ease because the dogs are
not disturbing them anymore.
They are not disturbing them anymore. So Mama is cleaning everything up that Bobby and Wolfie scattered or destroyed before, because they love uprooting banana trees. You can see there, Mama burnt all the dead leaves and trunks. It's also nice because when you burn things, yeah, like kaingin, of course it's not really good for the atmosphere, but when it's controlled like this, it's small fire, it's beneficial for our crops.
Here, look at the sugar cane. I remember this. We had only a very small sprout that Jonathan found in the flood at home.
Flooding, yeah.
There was the flooding in Manila. And he brought it here and planted it here. This was it already yielded only one
stalk.
How do you call that? One stalk
before, but now it has multiple stalks.
Oh, this is now the second season since the time, and you can see it's almost 10. 1, 2, 3, 4.
No, that's not included. This is a leaf.
4. No, 1.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8.
And behind there.
Yeah.
8. And there are still more sprouting.
So we're still thinking if we're going to uproot this plant or we should include it at our weekend market at FDI Complex in Taguig. Aani Market.
Yes. Aani we are doing very well here because of the good nutrients that we have now in the farm.
Yeah.
Ever since, never happened with us yet. Yeah. Only now.
Only now. So, I guess you're wondering why I'm holding a basin again. Because one of our prize crops has a lot of roots. So, we're going to take it out, collect them for our weekend market on the 26th. See? Very nice. Because if you properly store pickling cucumbers, actually the trick is to keep them dry. Then when you're sure they're dry already, you can put it in a container or plastic bag that's you're sure that it's going to keep all the freshness in, and just put it in the refrigerator.
Yeah,
it can last for more than a month in the refrigerator, so it's still fresh if you properly store it. So we're going to take all the mature ones. We don't like them really big because it's more enjoyable to eat them.
Oh, there's too many there.
Yeah. I'm going to have, I think, more than 2 kilos now. I have a feeling.
Yeah.
This is the first harvest. You need to really take a look at it. Because
yeah, we will be back on Monday, so we can harvest
more.
The ones that are
still small,
not entirely. There is one down there, I do not know.
Here.
And this one down there.
Where?
I don't know. It's yeah. Well, it's a nice one, that one. Yeah.
We keep them. Not really big.
Yeah, so it's difficult to see. There are lots of leaves here.
Yeah.
You cannot just look through them. There are some there. Wow.
Yeah,
I will let you add it. Huh?
Yeah, and see you guys on the 26th at the FDI Complex, Aani Weekend Market.
Yeah.
And you will have a taste of our pure ecological produce.
Yeah. Okay.
So we have here a patch of marigolds that we planted. Actually, we tried planting before marigolds here, but we bought the marigolds from what do you call this? Places
seed
where
banks.
Not seed banks. At first.
Seed banks.
Yeah, at first, the seeds from seed banks, and we also tried marigolds from places where you can buy plants, ornamental plants, but they do not really work that well because most of them are hybrids. So what we did was, while driving home, looking around, if you see in a very like secluded place marigolds, most of the time those marigolds are native marigolds. So you just stop and ask if somebody owns the plant and just ask permission, get the seeds from it, and then plant them. Because marigolds, when they start maturing and flowering and having seeds in their flowers, those flowers just wither and the seeds just drop the same place where they are, where their like mother plant is planted on, and it becomes so saturated and it's very nice for the eye, especially when they're having flowers. And it's very beneficial because it attracts beneficial insects that pollinate our crops. If you can see here, if you follow me, marigolds are like, you can compare them to touch-me-nots in terms of their seeds just sprouting beside the mother plant, like this. These are touch-me-nots. The reason why we call them touch me nots is, if you can see, there's a pod here. It's not yet mature, but we're going to force it. If you just press it, it springs open and spews out seeds. See? So like when birds go against them, or Bobby and Wolfie.
Or when they're already mature, they dry up a little bit, and they just pop open.
Yeah, it just explodes.
I think that's one that popped open here.
Yeah, it just springs and flings out all the seeds.
It's already popped open.
You can see here, seeds.
Yeah.
So touch me nots are native to the Philippines. So if you have them at the farm, do not take them, because they are flowering plants. They are also beneficial to attract insects that are useful in the...
Yes, and they are called touch me not, because once you touch them, they pop.
Yeah, do not touch me or I'll pop. So, the Eco Backyard Farm is a pure ecological farm, because I'm in a thread, a discussion on Facebook, but I'm not going to go into details. When you say pure organic farming, you do not import things. You do things on your own. You make things on your own. Why? Because you know what's in it. Because you're the one who made it. Unlike when you go commercial and products that claim that they are organic, you can only read the backside of that product. Oh, the ingredients are like this. But do you really know what's in it?
No.
No. So, extra juice, man.
We say paper is very willing, you know.
Yeah.
You can write anything on paper.
Yeah, you can write anything on paper. So, you're not really sure what's in it.
Yes. Yeah,
so... if you use it in your garden or farm, and it takes effect immediately, then you should think twice.
Yes.
Because nothing in nature goes that fast.
Yeah, it smells...
kind of fishy.
Yeah.
Yeah. So when you talk about pure ecological farming, you should know as a farmer what's in your crops or what you use for ecological or pure organic fertilizers or extracts, something to that effect, or anything to that effect. So that's the big difference when you make your own or just buy products from the market which claim that they are organic, and you can see all the, so to say, components at the back, and you're not really sure what's in it.
Yeah.
So anyway, yes. Yeah.
That's it.
So,
but it's more difficult to make your own.
Yeah. And it's always a choice.
Yeah.
If you want to be healthier, or if you want to live healthy.
And another thing is, in nature, nothing is 1, 2, 3.
Yeah, nothing is 1, 2, 3. You do not monocrop. Huh?
No.
If you plant a huge space with only one crop, that's kind of fishy. It's not organic. Yeah.
So you may say, before it was something else, and now I put this, so I'm... rotating, but you see there is also something like diversity in eco-farming.
As you can see here at our...
Yes, we have all kinds of things here. We have leafy, we have different herbs.
Yeah, and this is artichoke.
Yeah, this is even artichoke.
Yeah, we already shown
you all. So we have potting crops here.
Yeah.
We have fruit crops there.
Yeah.
You see, this is arugula, which is actually a cabbage crop. You see, so different crops. We have celery there, but we have to harvest it soon.
Yeah. We're going to include that at our weekend market.
So you have all kinds of things. Here we have again some herbs, basil. You see, so there's a lot of variety. We even have sugarcane.
Yeah, we even have sugarcane. So if it's only one crop for a very big piece of land, again, think twice.
Because of diversity, different crops protect and help each other. That's why we put them together.
That's how nature balances itself.
Yes. When you go in the wild, you never see a monocrop in the wild.
Yeah. You don't see all banana trees at one place. There will be a lot of bananas, but in between, there are other crops.
If you see a lot of banana trees, that's a plantation made by man.
Yeah, made by man.
Okay.
Or you can see a plane on top of it spraying whatever they want to spray on their crops. But anyway, so that's the big difference between commercial and pure organic farming. If you're going to say you're organic, do it 100%. Or do not do it at all. Because if it's not 100% pure organic, it is not organic.
And you're fooling yourself.
You're fooling yourself.